God loves you with a love that is unfathomable to the human mind or heart. Now think about that a moment. There is a consuming longing in the heart of man. I should say mankind. To be loved.
Jealous for me.
To have someone else care for you. I don't mean to feign love or with selfish motives which can turn to hate like that. But I mean with a love that will give itself for you. That's what God does with you. God never uses anyone in a selfish way. Never. Satan uses men, and when there's nothing left and he's squeezed every drop out, he throws them down. Oh, but God loves you. He loves you more than you'll ever know. This moment in heaven, think of it. The streets are paved with gold. The walls are of jasper. The gates of solid pearl. If in your human eye you could see the throne of God, you would stand in raptured splendor. And he looks through that down here at me and you. Bankrupt. Sick. Lost. And loves us.
And God wants me to tell you something today that's going to come right out of this book. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. That whosoever, that means you. That whosoever, that means him. Believes in him. Puts their faith, their trust in him. They will not perish. They will not die and go to hell. They will not.
Love is the final purpose of world history, the amen of the universe. Love is the greatest thing in the world. The scripture says, herein is love. Not that we loved God, but that he loved us. God doesn't want you to be lost. So much so that he gave his son on the cross for our sins. In other words, when Christ died on the cross, he was expressing the love of God toward you and by his death, covering your sins.
It was because he loved us. He loved you. He loved me. He loved this world. Oh, just by trusting in him, trusting that he sent his only son, Jesus, to die on the cross for you. And if you believe that with all your heart, Jesus will come in and change your life and pour into your heart his love, true love, real love.
Jesus came only to go to the cross. In that one act of love, in that one act of grace, he freely gave to all those who believe, cleansing from sin, eternal life, and a home for all eternity at his side in heaven.
Jesus died on the cross, and he died on that cross while I was a sinner. The Bible says he loved me when I was unlovable. Bible says he demonstrated his love for us, and that while we were yet sinners, he died for
us. I don't care if you only have 5 breaths left in your body. If you'll just call on the name of Jesus Christ, he will touch you and he will save you where you are. It doesn't matter what mire you've been in. His grace is greater than your failure. He loves you.
He loves you tonight. I said he loves you tonight. I don't care who you are. God loves you. If you're an alcoholic, God loves you. If you're on drugs, God loves you. I don't care what you're going through. God loves you. And he will move all of hell to rescue you.
The love of God crosses oceans. The love of God goes into the Roman Colosseums. The love of God lays down its life. The love of God sheds its blood. The love of God goes into the jungles. The love of God goes into the hovels. The love of God goes into the hospitals. The love of God, how deep, how pure, how great.
He loves you so much.
He's going to adopt you into his family. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's going to give you his name. You don't have a name. You're an orphan. Jimmy Swaggart was an orphan. But he's going to give you his name. Christian. Meaning Christ one. One in Christ.